Where should we mark a point inside this highlighted triangle so the sum of the three distances from the point to the vertices of the triangle is the smallest? In the future, we will solve this problem geometrically and very gracefully. But as for today, we are going to dive into an equally amazing discussion. Imagine that the line segments starting from the yellow node are threads that are trying to reach the vertices. We will make holes in these vertices and tie three weights of equal mass to them. As a result, the system will be in equilibrium with minimal potential energy, meaning that hanging threads will have the longest length in sum. Then, the sum of the lengths starting from the node will be the smallest. And we now have just solved the Stiener tree problem. Please notice that the forces acting on the node are directed along the threads, and they are also equal in absolute value. So if we sum them together, they will neutralize each other. It means that the sum of any two vectors is equal to the negative of the third vector. It is possible only if the angle between any two vectors equals 120 degrees. There are two points inside the acute angle. Where should we place another two points on the sides of the angle, so the length of the yellow polyline will be the minimal? Let's do the same thing we do in the Fagnani's problem. Reflect fixed points over the sides of the angle. Now we can transfer these two line segments and further focus on the new polyline with the same length. So right now, think about where should we place the points. The sum of the lengths of links isn't less than the length of the line segment that connects the endpoints of the polyline. But how do we reach the minimum? When does inequality become equality? Only if the points B and C lie on the line segment A1D1. The problem is solved. But what do we need physics for? Think about the ray of light that starts from the fixed point, then reflects off every side of the angle, and finally ends up at another point. According to the Fermat's principle, light follows the shortest optical path. Let's take a closer look at how exactly this happens. The angles shown in the picture are equal due to the symmetry, and these two angles are vertical. It means that the angles that I'm highlighting right now are also equal. The same story happens with the angles formed by the right ray. Therefore, we should place points B and C so that the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Next, let's try to remember the three forces principle. We can gorgeously prove a lot of facts related to the concurrency of three lines using it. For example, you already know that the three angle bisectors of a triangle intersect at the single point. But how can we explain it in terms of physics? Imagine that the triangle is a rigid body and three people are vainly trying to move it. We need to find three vectors directed along the bisectors so that their sum would be zero. How can we guess it beforehand for any given triangle? It's very simple. First of all, we will add pairs of vectors from the triangle vertices. If you want the resultant force of every pair out of these three to be directed along the bisectors, logically you have to choose forces that are equal in absolute value for every pair. Besides that, these two forces of opposite directions should neutralize each other, meaning that the absolute values should be equal too. So in the end, we have six forces with equal lengths. And now we sum every pair of vectors according to the parallelogram law. And here we have three desirable vectors lying on the bisectors. But now we know for sure that these three non-parallel vectors act on a rigid body in equilibrium, hence its lines of action intersect at a single point, what was to be shown. Thank you. Lastly, he is a discrete charm of the mass method that is already adored by some of you. First, try to prove yourself that the medians of any triangle intersect at a single point. And together, we will place unit masses at the vertices of the triangle. We can group these two bottom ones and place them at the midpoint of the line segment. But note that the mass will double. Then we will find the center of mass of this system using the lever rule. Please note that the point with a mass of 3 divides the median in the ratio 2 to 1, starting from the vertex. Now let's find the center of mass another way. Firstly, let's regroup these two points, and then those two that are left. The center of mass is located on another median, but it also divides the median in the ratio of 2 to 1. Turns out, the center of mass lies on this line segment as well as on another. And since there is only one center of mass, it is located at the intersection of the line segments, and it also lies on the third median. It means that we not only proved that the medians of a triangle are concurrent, but also found out that their intersection point divides them in the ratio of 2 to 1, starting from the vertex. If you like this topic, write it in the comment section below. Think critically, do math, take care!